Hello, art people. Welcome to day two of our ceramic measuring cups. Now we're going to make a coil. So get a piece of clay that is about this size and squish it into what we called last time a fuzzy caterpillar. And then you can go ahead and roll it into a coil, just like last time. So back and forth on your tray, and when it gets flat, twist it a bit, and then continue. Remember, you're going to go until it's about the width of your finger. Now we are going to score. So take a little clay tool and just draw lines on the top of your coil. And now we will need water for the slip. Once you have your water, just touch the very top of the water and dab little drops of water on top of the score or the little scratches you made. And now we need our project that we started last time. So. Okay, once you have your project, go ahead and get it out of your Ziploc bag, and you can just set your post-it aside. And then we're going to score or scratch or draw lines on the top of this project here. Okay, good job. So now, just like you did with the coil, dab little drops of water on the top of your coil pot. Great job. Now you can take your coil and place it on the coil pot so the scratches are touching each other. And you can just pinch off any extra coil and kind of smush the clay together on the ends there. And press it down so it is squished right on there, and then you can smooth the sides out. Great job. You can smooth the sides out on the inside of your coil pot as well. We're going to make another coil now, so if you are the puppy dog, you can go ahead and give people a little bit more clay if they need it, but you're just going to do the exact same thing as last time. So making a coil and then attaching it to the top of your coil pot. If you forget what to do, just turn your card red and I will come over and remind you, or better yet, you could ask somebody at your table, because I bet somebody at your table has it memorized how to attach a coil to a coil pot. So we're just making the wall a little bigger or a little taller now. Okay, so on the bottom of your coil pot, I need you guys to carve the number that you're sitting at. So if you're at seat one, carve a one. If you're at seat two, carve a two, so on and so forth. And I find it easiest to carve with a paper clip. So if there's a stretched out paper clip in the clay tools, just ask the puppy dog and they will get it to you. You guys might need to share. And if there's not a paper clip, then the puppy dogs can ask me for one and I'll give it to them because they're in charge of the clay tools. So you guys can go ahead and carve your number in the bottom and then you can continue just smoothing it out and making it look what you guys want it to look like. Okay, so I actually went ahead and did a third coil on mine. So if you guys want to do a third coil on yours, you can. You're welcome to do that. This is the last day we're going to be building our coil pot, though, so just keep that in mind. We have about 10 minutes left or so to work, and then we need to clean up. Another thing you could do as well is to carve designs on the side. So I did some swirlies on mine, some zigzags, some flowers, hearts, whatever you guys want to do. If you wanted to put something on, like a design on the coil pot, just remember that you have to score, slip, stick, and smooth in order for it to actually stick on. You can't just like make a dot and then push it on the coil pot and assume that it's not going to fall apart because it will fall off unless you do the score, slip, stick, and smooth. So you guys can do whatever you guys want to do with these coil pots. We have about 10 minutes, like I said, and then we'll go ahead and clean up. It is now time to clean up. So the first thing we'll do is roll up all of our clay, all of our extra clay, and give it to the puppy dog so they can put the extra clay back. Now it is time to give your clay tools to the puppy dog so they can put the clay tools back. Now you can give your cup of water to the puppy dog and they'll put that away. All right, now put your coil pot next to your bear, and the bear is gonna put away your coil pots for you guys and turn those in. We don't need to put them in a bag this time because we do want them to dry out. So bear, take your time. You can just do two at a time. You don't have to do all four coil pots at a time, but go ahead and turn those in for your table. Okay, alligators, go ahead and get the tray inserts. Make yourself a pile of tray inserts. Those are going to go at my sink. And then you can put the trays away too. And lastly, kitty cats, if you could get the Ziploc bags for me and put those away, that would be wonderful. And then you guys are all done. So we'll wash our hands and come back in. And you guys did a great job today. Thanks for watching. I'll see you in the next one.